Hello everyone, very good morning to all of you students. Welcome back to the session of Building Construction Technology. This is Ishani Trivedi from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. So students, we have been discussing constantly about the various building components. So in the last session, in the previous session, we were discussing about the specific type of building component called flooring. Now you know that students, flooring is important for us because it is the place where we live, where we dwell. It is the flat surface which is available for the use of occupants, for any kind of occupants, for any type of building, any type of structure. You require a flat surface or a flat flooring, right? So in the previous session we discussed about the various classification of upper floor. Now if you remember, then we have three different categories for the flooring, right? What are those categories? We have ground floor, we have upper floor, and we have the roof, right? So in this session we are going to complete with the upper floors, and then we will start with the basic concepts of the topmost story, the roof, or the roof and the roof covering also. Because if you are providing different types of roof, then sometimes you will also have to provide certain types of covering based on the type of the roof. Okay, so let us continue back with the third type of upper floor which we were discussing already. In the upper floor, we already discussed about two types. First was timber flooring, second was flagstone flooring. Both of them were resting on the joist. The difference in the wooden timbering, flooring was that it was resting on wooden joist, and the flagstone was resting on the which type of joist? RSJ, rolled steel joist. Now we had moved to the third type, that is your jack arch flooring. Now in the arch flooring, again we will have two different categories. We will have brick jack arch flooring and we will have concrete jack arch flooring. Correct? So we were already done with the brick jack arch flooring. All the technical points and the sketch and the image is flashing again over here, so that you can match the link that we were discussing about the jack arch flooring, and we are done with the brick type of flooring, so that we can move, we can derive the concrete jack arch flooring from the same. So you know that how the cross section can be drawn at suitable intervals. At certain intervals you will have to provide your mild steel, roll steel joist, RSJ, right? You know about the points that you have to prevent them from rusting. You know how the brick arch construction is carried out, because we have already been done with the types of centering. That was the temporary work for the arch construction. So I think if you match all of these things, then it will be easy for you to connect and write down the theories. Make sure that you draw the sketch properly. Now moving forward to the second type is concrete jack arch flooring. Now let us try to understand the difference between the brick jack arch and concrete jack arch. Look at the image, the cross section which is flashing over here. Now concrete jack arch flooring will be nothing but it will be appearing just like an arch made up of concrete, right? There is nothing much to think about it, but we have to understand the internal construction of the same. Otherwise you know everything, right? So how this type of construction is done? Again, this will have intermediate support of rolled steel joist, mild steel joist. That will be common in brick jack arch and concrete jack arch, because for the if not RSJ, then you will have to provide beams, because for the load transfer mechanism you have to compulsory provide a structural element. So now here you can see we have the arch flooring, the arch construction. Concrete mix specifically will be used of 1:2:4. See, you can have other variations also. It is not compulsory to provide this type of mix, but according to standard conditions you have to provide cement:sand:aggregate. That mix will be 1:2:4, okay, and which is constructed with the help of this concrete mix. Your arch will be constructed. For construction of arch, what will you require? You will require centering. Now here, make sure that wooden centering will not be provided, right? Here steel centering will be provided. The turning piece, right, the segmental piece, the turning piece will be made up of a steel plate, mild steel plate. MS steel plate will be made matching the shape of your intrados of the required arch construction. And also this plate will have holes in between, and between these holes a steel rod will be provided. It will be clamped for better stability and stable construction, which you can also see in the second image flashing below the jack arch construction. That is your section or the figure, the drawing for the centering, that how the centering piece, mild steel piece or the plate is prepared with holes in it, and steel rods are passed through it for better stability, and that will be your centering for the jack arch construction of concrete flooring. So what do we have in the technical points? We have that arches of cement concrete of 1:2:4 is prepared, and which are supported on the flanges of mild steel, that is your rolled steel joist. About the centering, as I said, your centering will be a steel plate which will be almost 3 mm thick. You can have 3 to 5 mm thick also. They are bent. They are bent to match the shape of the intrados for the arch soffit. Soffit means the internal width. You are aware with the technical terms of the arch already. Okay, then you have that steel plates will have holes. As I said, that holes will be there, and a rod will be connecting both of those holes. It will be passing through it. But at what distance? It will be located at distance of 75 centimeter to center to center all along the length, right? Iron rods, as I said, of 12 mm diameter. See, I explained the concept already. Now we have is the technicality, the technical dimensions of all of these things. Otherwise the construction is very simple, and then the process which I explained remains the same. Okay, the flooring is kept wet for 10 days. Obviously for concreting work you will have to carry out the curing work. So once your flanges, that is your rolled steel joist, will be fixed and the concreting work will be done, and your arch construction will be achieved. So this has to be cured for at least 10 days, and once the curing process is done, then you can provide the top layer, that is the flooring. What you constructed over here was your sub base, your base layer, and on top of that comes your flooring, which are the two basic components of the construction of flooring. On top of that you can provide tiled flooring, you can provide concrete flooring. It depends on what type you require. Okay, and the surface is also plastered. If you have provided concrete flooring, then you can plaster it and make it better for the appearance purpose. Okay students, so this covers your full of your upper floors. So we are done with ground floor, we are done with upper floor, and now we are moving to the third type, that is your uppermost story, that is your last story of the building, that is roof. Now, okay students, I think we have missed out on one more type of upper floor also. So let us talk about it, then we will talk about roof, okay. We have the next type of flooring known as, what do you read the name, right? We have the hollow block flooring. We have the hollow block flooring or ribbed flooring. The name is quite different, right? It seems that something is different over here. But see, if you look at the real image which is flashing here, I think you have seen lot many types of such flooring in the construction which is carried out in recent times. If you are passing through any construction site, then please have a look. You also have this type of flooring in your institute campus as well. If you see the law school, then at the entrance itself from the outside you can see that such type of flooring is provided. Now what can you see in this type of flooring? Okay, the flooring is going to be a normal flat surface where you can step on, but at the bottom you can see that hollow blocks are provided, right? Square boxes are provided which are empty in between. Correct? So now, if I want to give it a name of a waffle slab, do you know what is a waffle? Yes, you know that. So if you observe the waffle, then you will have number of checkered sections, right? You will have number of boxes on it. The same appears over here. So in layman language, in simple language, you can call it as a waffle slab. So now actual technical name of this waffle slab is ribbed flooring or hollow block flooring. The name itself says hollow block flooring, right? So now look at the cross section at the top, which you can see how this kind of flooring is constructed. So the flooring, as I said, is going to remain flat, right? But at the bottom, what can you see? That concreting work is done, full slab is constructed, but in between empty spaces are kept. Look at the cross section at the top. You can see above in the cross section. What can you see over there? You have the flooring at the top, correct? And then at bottom, again, concreting work is done, but only at centers. The middle space is kept empty. You can see blocks are provided over there, correct? Now these blocks may be provided with empty spaces, hollow spaces. You can provide suitable covering also, but you can see that a T-beam effect is created. Can you see that? You will have the slab above the ribbed, above the hollow blocks, you have a slab, right? And that slab is having another structural member vertically, right, with the blocks left in between. So this gives you effect of a T-beam, which is even more stable. You will study about the T-beams in detail in your further semester, in your further higher education, about the design of a T-beam, right? So this type of flooring is known as ribbed flooring. Now, what are the advantages of this type of flooring? Why do you need to provide this? First of all, where is it provided? It is provided in all general buildings, in schools, in offices, in public buildings, right, where the span is large. As I said, that it is present in your institute campus also, right? And if you pass through the construction of commercial sites right now, then you will be able to see this type of flooring also. So where the span is large, where the span is huge, you can use this type of flooring for upper floors, right? Second thing, because the space in between is kept empty, it can be one blocks, it can be two blocks at a time also. Because the space is kept empty, it is hollow, right? Then what will happen is, you will have the overall dead load will be decreased. Hence, lightweight sections can be prepared with the help of this type of flooring. Also, it will be able to carry all types of dead load, live load coming from the top, right? Sometimes reinforcement has to be, additional reinforcement has to be provided if more amount of stresses or load is generated. Otherwise, this is ideal construction where the span is large, that is your school buildings, office buildings, etc. So let us talk about it, that the ribs, the hollow blocks which are provided, behave like the T-beams, as I said. The space between the ribs is filled with hollow blocks made of clay, fiberglass, PVC or concrete. As I said, suitable covering has to be provided to these blocks. So these blocks will be made up of different materials, glass fiber or PVC being common these days. Okay, so this way your ribs or blocks will be provided at the empty space. We talked about the use at various places. I told you that where it is used. If heavy UDL, that means if heavily uniformly distributed load is coming on it, then ribs are provided in both the directions. The image which is flashing over here itself is in two directions, right? So it, as I said, that reinforcement additional may also have to be provided, and two direction ribs are also common for heavy loads coming on this type of flooring. Next, what do you have? It is light in weight, which we already discussed. Then also it will provide thermal insulation, sound insulation, right? Both of these things are, these were the basic requirements of a flooring if you remember, right? So it will provide you thermal and sound insulation, both better. Also, the installations, it means the electrical wiring or any other kind of wiring will become easier. It will be easy to open them or it will be easy to pass the wirings and the installation. Optical fiber cables, which is common these days, it is provided in new construction, right, for internet purpose, broadband purpose. So all of these things will become easy when you have constructed this type of flooring. Okay students, one more image I am flashing over here about the ribbed flooring, so that it becomes more and more clear to you in your mind that how this type of construction appears. Now moving forward to the last type of flooring, I will call this now as roof, right? Because this structural element itself has its own design, its own provisions, its own requirements. So after ground floor and upper floor, we are taking the last topmost story, that is your roof, and also if covering is provided, then roof coverings. Okay, so now we are moving to the last type, that is roof. Now look at the image flashing above me. Can you see that? What are the roof, right? If I want to define it separately, if I want to define it technically, then roof is the uppermost, the top story of a building, the top floor of a building, right? Now it is also supposed to protect you from the adverse effects of wind, sun, rain, frost, if it is a cold country, right? From any kind of atmospheric changes, from any kind of weather conditions, from storm, from if we talk about foreign countries, then also there are natural calamities like tornadoes, right? So the roof is supposed to protect you from all type of adverse effect of the weather, of the atmosphere. Hence its construction will be a little bit different as compared to the ground floor and upper floor. Now the image which you can see over here is flashing you different types of roof, okay? But if I ask you what are the types of the roof, then two things will come in your mind. One is flat roof, where you are living right now, because mostly almost 90% cases are flat roof in the city areas. Also currently in the rural areas, in the village areas also, flat roof is becoming popular. And second, you will have the sloped roof. Sloped roof will be called as pitched roof or slope roof and flat roof. You also have domes, right? You have seen the heritage buildings, the monuments, right? So we also have curved surfaces. About the factories, if you have seen the factories, then it will have curved roof. So three types are available. Based on that, we will have lots of variations in the pitch roof, right? So which is flashing over here, you can have a look at it. We will be discussing all of them in detail. Then we have the coverings, right? Different types of coverings on the pitch roof has to be provided. You can have stone covering, you have slate covering, you have AC sheets, right? You have the aluminium sheets, then you have galvanized iron sheets, that is GI sheets, right? So different types of coverings are available. You have wooden shingles also, right? So different types of covering will be discussed, which is also flashing above in front of you. You can have a look at the different type of coverings of for the roof. Now we will have certain essential requirements. I think like we have discussed all the essential requirements in different type of building component, this will also have certain requirements, right? For an ideal roof, what do you require? I think you know about one point already, that it has to protect from the adverse effect of the temperature, wind, sun, rain, frost, everything. That is definite reason, requirement, okay? Also, it will have sound insulation and thermal insulation. I think these requirements you will be able to write on your own also. I am pretty sure about that, okay? So it should be strong to carry all the dead and live loads, which is obvious thing, which is a requirement for the floor also, okay? Waterproofing and drainage provisions, because when rainwater comes, then proper drainage has to be done, proper slope has to be provided, okay? So drainage provisions, heat and sound insulation, fire resistance is common in all type of building components. Okay students, so we shall keep up to here now about the concept of roof, that is your upper story or upper flooring. In the further sessions, we will discuss more about the types of roof, its sketches, its roof coverings and all of those things. Okay students, so let us keep till now today. Thank you students.